Hey, I'm Mac. Welcome back to my channel. I have a bit of a weird angle on MLMs that I'd like to talk about today. So this is going to focus on the overall infeasibility of the math of MLMs. Often we tend to focus on whether or not MLM participants are being truthful in their income claims and whether those income claims are realistic for the people that they're trying to recruit. But today, I would like to examine whether it is even possible for a significant number of MLM participants to make a livable income based on the sales that the consultants make, because the money's got to be coming in from somewhere. So is it even possible? Ultimately, the MLM company takes in money from the sales of the products to ostensibly their retail customers and likely in reality from sales to their consultants. So how much product would there need to be moved in order for there to be enough revenue to provide a living wage to a number of people? So I'm gonna go with the low end of what is considered to be a living wage nationwide with $12 an hour. Now that might be higher than what's needed in some very rural areas, and it's definitely not even close to what is needed in cities like Los Angeles or New York City, but it's close to the average necessary living wage nationwide. Assuming full-time work, that is $24,960 a year. Now I'm going to go through some very basic business terms that we probably all know, but just in case. So gross margin on a product is the retail sale price minus the cost to acquire the goods, or the cost of goods sold, or the COGS. So it's the amount of money that the business will have after the sale available to put towards profit, toward expenses, towards payroll, etc. It's whatever they didn't pay to get the product from their supplier. The markup on a product is what is going to determine the gross margin. So usually a product is marked up anywhere from 100 to 150% retail. So if I'm selling umbrellas and I get the umbrellas from my supplier for $10 and I sell them for $20 to my retail customers, that's a 100% markup. And that's very standard for retail. Retail is almost always a 100% markup at least. So on each sale, I have $20 in revenue, a cost of goods sold of $10, and a gross profit of $10. Normally payroll is gonna be 25 to 50% of your gross profit. After all, there are other expenses that need to be taken care of than just payroll. So if my store on an average day sells 50 umbrellas, I would have $1,000 in revenue for the day, $500 cost of goods sold, and $500 gross profit. If I have one employee in the whole store the whole day, and I pay her $16 an hour for her 8-hour workday, her total is $128 in wages for the day, which is 26% of my gross profit, which is just about right. And we could also work backwards on this. So if I wanna have one $12 an hour employee, and this is my only employee, and I don't pay myself, to have it be 25% of gross profit, then I need to have a gross profit of $99,840 per year at least. In order to make $99,840 a year in gross profit, I need to make about $200,000 a year in revenue based on my 100% markup. Since I sell my umbrellas for $20, then I need to sell 10,000 umbrellas every year to meet my goals. So hopefully Rihanna is looking for a sequel or something and maybe we can get a deal with that. So I'm gonna go back in on Young Living since I was already picking on their income disclosure. Okay, so they sell their Thieves essential oil for wholesale $34.75 and retail $45.72, which is already a suspiciously low markup. I kind of don't believe that their wholesale price actually means wholesale, because that's a markup of 32%, but let's take them at their word for now. I know it's dangerous to take an MLM at their word, but we're gonna live dangerously today. So based on those figures, if we believe them, The gross profit per unit would be 1097. In order for a Hun to make $24,960 and cover her own pay like a normal business would, and let's be generous, and we'll put 50% of gross profit toward payroll, we'll need a gross profit of $49,920. All right, so $49,920 divided by 1097 per unit means we would need to sell 4,551 units of this oil if it were the only product being sold per year, which is 87 units per week, or 17 units per workday if you work 5 days a week, which no Hun does, but whatever. So that's 13 units per day if you work every single day. So what does this mean? It means that for every one Young Living representative that we're making a living wage, we would need to have sales of 4,551 units of this product if it were the only product and the only source of revenue. But their ratios of retail to wholesale price are similar across all their products, though, and the thieves oil is quite expensive, so this is probably an underestimate since the markup is the same on all of their products, which means that the gross margin is going to be larger on thieves simply because the numbers are bigger. I have to wonder how many Young Living distributors sell over 4,500 units of oils per year. But I have to suspect that there are very, very few who make numbers like that. More likely, what Young Living calls their wholesale price is actually their retail price. So let's examine that scenario. We're gonna assume 100% markup, but it's probably higher for Young Living. So 3475 over 2 is 1738 gross profit per unit. And we need to start looking at this from the company perspective. So, since we're treating the wholesale price as the retail price, we're going to assume, probably correctly, that the consultants are the customers. So, for an upline Hun to be making a living wage of $24,960 per year, they'll need to have approximately $100,000 in revenue coming in because the gross profit's gonna be half, and then the payroll is going to be 50% of gross profit. So that's $100,000 in revenue or 100,000 volume points. So let's extrapolate. Each consultant is required to make 100 personal volume per month, which means they have to purchase $100 in products every single month that they want to stay active. That's 1,200 PV per year, $1,200. Which means that in order to make that $100,000 revenue target, you would need $100,000 over 1,200, which is about 83. That's 83 downline consultants in order to pay yourself a living wage. That sounds a lot more likely. So what we have determined is that if we assume all revenue comes from the downline consultants, for every one consultant that makes a living wage, we must have a minimum of 83 consultants that are making no money. Otherwise, there's just not enough revenue coming into Young Living because there's no way that they're making the sales that we talked about earlier. But this does sound more likely. This sounds more like it. Unless there are some mystery retail sales that we don't know about, the money's gonna come from somewhere. Now let's look at those other income levels, because that was only talking about a living wage. What about these supposed distributors who are making like six figures? They always love to spout that one off. But that would mean we need a gross profit of $200,000. So on the retail side, if the story about product sales is legit, if that's how they're really making money, then they would need to sell 200,000 over 1079 gross profit. So for thieves. So let's, and I'm gonna just call that like thieves per year, thieves per hour, thieves per day. So they would need to sell 18,536 units of thieves per year in order to support one consultant making $100,000 a year. That would be it. That would be the minimum retail requirement if that were true. But if the consultants are the only customers, then for every one distributor that makes $100,000 a year, there would need to be 167 consultants making nothing. And that sounds a lot more likely. That makes sense. I could see that. I don't see them selling 18,500 units of thieves or of any oil. So what about for that $500,000 level? So you would need a gross profit of $1 million to get that from supposed retail sales to outside customers. You would need to sell 92,678 units of oils or have 1,667 zero income distributors. Again, that sounds a lot more likely. In fact, I think that's very close to their compensation plan requirements. And for the $1 million, you would need to gross $2 million. For the legitimate retail explanation, that's 185,357 units of oils per year, or have 3,333 members in your downline making nothing. And for that top income on their income disclosure statement, which was $3.5 million, you would need to gross $7 million per year by selling either 648,749 units of oils, or have 11,667 consultants below you making nothing. Again, that sounds about right. I'm pretty sure the consultants are the customers then, because I don't think there's not some crazy like hidden sales. Okay, no one buys this shit except for the distributors and like their two friends who feel bad, you know, and won't be their friends for long enough. The point I'm making is not that these numbers are like gonna be accurate with precision, because there's just not enough information that I have access to in their books. I'm just showing you how there's some math here that has to add up. There has to be money going into a business and out of a business. There has to be enough money coming in to pay money out. Otherwise, you don't have a business. So it just doesn't add up to being funded by the retail sales that are supposedly happening. It's just not the case. And the amount of consultants that are needed to be in a downline for the upline to make even a living wage shows you that not everybody is making money. There's just nowhere close to enough retail sales to even have a fraction of enough retail profit to pay distributors from on a broad scale. Even with the most generous assumptions, in the absence of an astronomical number of undisclosed retail sales we don't know are happening, it is a necessity for 83 consultants to make nothing in order to even have one consultant making a barely living wage. It takes 58 consultants making zero for every one consultant making just minimum wage, not even a living wage. That matches up with those numbers in that income disclosure statement kind of surprisingly well. And it sounds far, far more likely than the alternate scenario that, in fact, each of these distributors is unbeknownst to us moving hundreds of units of product in retail sales every single week and tens of thousands retail sales per year. That's just not happening. It's either there's secret retail sales happening or the one living wage to 83 screwed over zeros. One or it's the other, but that is just incontrovertible math. If money isn't coming in, it's not going out, and it's just not poofing in from nowhere. I've been Mac. Bye.